First of all, thumbnails are only used with playlists. To create a playlist, we need to download the core first. Download the core or the cores for the system that you want to create a playlist. Then we'll create a playlist by scanning files or folders. By scanning a folder with Nintendo 64 games, it will create a playlist with only those games that you have inside the folder. Now that we have the playlist, we can finally start downloading thumbnails, and there are a couple of ways to do that. If you open a game or click on the game, you'll see that there's a download thumbnails, and then you'll have the thumbnail for that specific game. You can do this manually for all the games, but that's just a pain in the ass. There are better ways to download thumbnails for a whole playlist. Now, to download thumbnails for the entire playlist, go to main menu, online updater, playlist, thumbnails updater, and then choose the playlist that you want to download the thumbnails. And now, as you see, you can see that we have all thumbnails for the whole games in that playlist. Now to the thumbnails on demand. Go to the main menu, online updater, scroll down to the bottom, and you'll see on demand thumbnail downloads. Now, if you go to your playlist, this will download thumbnails while you're scrolling down the playlist or while you're navigating. It will just download the games while you scroll through it. Now for the final and last way of downloading thumbnails on RetroArch, which is one that I don't recommend. Go to the main menu, scroll down to User Interface, Views, and scroll down until you see Show Legacy Thumbnails Updater. Press on, then go to Online Updater, and you'll see that there's a new option there. It's called Thumbnails Updater. This will download all the thumbnails that are available for that console. It will download all the thumbnails for all the games of that console, even the ones you don't play and you'll never play. This is why I really don't recommend, because this will just waste space on your PC.